it's pretty flattering. I have a lot of respect for a lot of the coaches that I coach against in the conference, and for them to think that we're the top team, it's humbling and flattering. To be honest with you, I was quite shocked, because St. Vincent has won the last seven conference titles, and I couldn't see anybody picking us over them. So, but it's flattering, yeah. I mean, winning the conference championship is goal number one, or it is a goal. It's not our top goal. This group got together back in May before the summer began, and they laid it out there by themselves that they want to qualify for nationals. So whatever it takes to do that, I think we're going to have several kids being a top 35 in the region, make all region. And, you know, individually, we'd like to have an All-American out of this group, Harley Moyer. But I think they are pretty much self-driven. And I will meet with them to talk to them about their goals, and I will support them in any way that I possibly can. Well, like I just said, I think Harley has put it out there. He has a goal of becoming an All-American, not just making a national championship meet. And missed the national meet by 11 seconds last year, finishing 18th in the region. So I would say top five in the region for him, top 35 at NCAAs. And I would say he's the front runner to win the conference, although that's never a given, a slam dunk. And Grant's just come a long way. He actually had a cross-country season that wasn't the best. He was coming off a stress fracture his senior year in high school in track. So we got some distance under his belt, and he just jumped to another level in track season here as a freshman. So again, I would say that his goal would be to run as close to Harley as he possibly can the entire year. Okay, some of our returning runners, Shane Burkhart from Bethel Park. He had a phenomenal freshman year. Last year he had some health problems. We had a transfer last year as a sophomore, Gary Olson, who came from Point Park University. He was the second best runner as a freshman on their national championship qualifying team. He was fifth in his conference. We have a load of freshmen coming in. Alec Dravish was sixth in the conference last year in the 10K. Colin Meehan's a senior. He's put a lot of time in, a lot of miles in. Our freshmen include Trey Razanoskis from Seneca Valley. He was fifth in the WPIL in cross country. He was a WPL runner-up in the 3200 this spring, his senior year. Ben Heim, another freshman, a complete stud. Ben was a 155-800 kid as a junior in high school, and he finished ninth in the state as a senior in high school in his in the state championship in Singaway. Billy Lott has had a phenomenal summer. Billy's an unbelievable runner as well. He had some health problems his senior year in cross country. But he had a pretty good track season. He has a PR of 4:26 in a mile, ran 9:59 in the 3200 as a sophomore. He was 10th in the WPL as a sophomore. Anthony Voto, he's another kid who's worked very hard from Newcastle. He was 10th in the WPL in cross country as a junior. He's put a lot of time in, a lot of miles in this summer. So we're pretty darn deep. So I think I named all the guys in addition to the top two that we had already talked about, and any one of those seven guys can be in our top five or seven. We just don't know how it's going to pan out. Contributions that our freshmen are going to make, this is kind of a bold statement, but Harley Moyer had an unbelievable freshman year. He finished second in the conference as a freshman in cross country. He won the indoor conference championship in the 5K. I think we have three or four guys who could run as well as Harley did as a freshman. I think that says a lot right there. So we have high expectations for them. We're still a program who relies on freshmen. We expect our freshmen to come in and perform right off the bat, and that's what's going to happen. The other PAC schools, obviously St. Vincent, in my mind, they're number one. No one's knocked them off. They've won seven in a row. There's a lot of strong teams in our conference. Grove City's always good. Thomas Moore's Studley, they have they're very deep as well, and Brian Yeller does a great job at Geneva. I'd say that would be probably the top five at the end of the year when it all shakes out.